Hello friends, welcome back. In this session, we are going to see the different image types, which is a very important interview topic, as well as this is most frequently asked question everywhere. Whenever you go, you must have come across the types of images like JPEG, TIFF, all these types of images you are very well aware of, and we need to know more technically about it. So this session is targeted towards getting you a clear knowledge as in what are all the types of images available and why are they different, what are all the pros and cons, that's it. So what is image type? Very simple. What is image format all about? It is nothing but a predefined and a standard way of organizing a digital image. Very simple. Whenever you have an image, how do you organize it, how do you store it, is based on a predefined way. And we have got multiple methods and multiple schemes to do it, and we name it as A type, B type image, and that's what we are going to do. And some images are compressed type and some images are non-compressed type. So we are going to see that also. So what is the benefit, what is the disadvantage, we will see all those also. The first type that we are going to see is tagged image file format, which is called TIFF, T-I-F-F. It is normally referred as a huge file format because it is very huge in size, and it is also called uncompressed image format, and it is very huge because it has all the information. It has got multiple color supports. It supports a vast range of colors, which include grayscale, CMY, RGB, and many more. And this is also called as lossless file format, which means there is no loss in the color, there is no loss in the content. But this is a very heavy file format, which means when you have to have a file stored in TIFF format, it will need more memory for it to be stored. So it has multiple pros and some cons as well that we are going to discuss right now. Very versatile and supports multiple color is the first pros that you need to understand. It's the first benefit. The second one, quality is not at all compromised. It is 100% perfect and it ensures complete quality. Coming to the disadvantages of it, the size is very huge and hence we got to spend more amount of space in storage. The second one is JPEG. This is the most popular, most frequently used format, and this is a compressed storage technique, which means that the image is well compressed and smaller in size would be the image's biggest benefit here. So it needs very little space for storage and hence people prefer it. All our digital cameras, when you take the default image type, storage is actually JPEG. JPEG is expanded as Joint Photographic Experts Group. TIFF is lossless because it doesn't compress the image, it retains all the quality, it retains multiple colors and all those things. But when you come to JPEG, it is actually a lossy compression technique. It uses compression, and hence the quality of the image, the color information, etc. would come a little low. And the biggest concern with JPEG is when you edit a JPEG image, when you re-edit it, when you do a further edit, the quality of the image is actually about to be lost, and which is actually a disadvantage for this type of image. The advantages are many. It is small size, reduced storage needs. The default image type is all JPEG almost in most of the digital cameras and other devices which captures image. This is pretty much apt for websites where the documents are getting loaded. And most important thing is this is compatible with most of the operating systems. The cons are also very high on the other side. The data, it discards the data because you compress it, it discards the data, and this could affect the content and the quality. And most importantly, it can give you a false observation the moment you start compressing it. The moment you start compressing it, you start losing data, which would create false artifacts. So you may understand something which is not true there with respect to the image, and transparency is definitely hurt in this type of image, in this type of storage. GIF format. GIF is graphics interchange format. It is nothing but it is an upgradation, I would say, from the previous two methods. It has the best features from the JPEG and TIFF together. From the TIFF, GIF has the quality. From the JPEG, it has got the storage scenario, which means it needs a reduced storage scenario where it also retains the quality just like TIFF. It is a lossless compression technique. Since it is lossless, it is lossless compression technique, but actually there is no loss in the content, which means that the size of the image is still still small, but the content is not lost. The size is reduced, but without content loss is the biggest advantage here. And most important aspect it, there is a negative aspect of it also. The negative aspect is nothing but the color ranges are very limited, which means that it would not support us with as many colors as we want. For example, if there are 5 shades of red available, GIF would only make it as only one shade. It would reduce it to one red and finally it would provide you that. For example, if there are 5 shades of green, it would make it one shade of green and it will provide you that. So we thereby lose the color information, we thereby lose the support for a number of vast ranges of colors. PROS, reduced size for the storage. This is absolutely small in size but with quality retainment. Suitable for images where multiple color shades are not required. Okay sir, my images will not have multiple colors. Can I use it? Yeah, it can be used. But cons, my images have multiple colors to be used. In that case, I cannot use it. Next one, PNG. PNG is nothing but an upgrade to the GIF. The GIF, as we saw, it is small in size but supports a very limited color option. So they came up with a better option where it supports multiple color options, and the most important point is the complete ranges of color is supported in PNG. The even then if you compare, JPEG is on the driver's seat because PNG still creates a larger file when you compare it to JPEG. PNG creates a larger file when you compare it to JPEG, and hence JPEG is still preferred over PNG. So PNG is nothing but portable network graphics. So advantages, this has got a better range of colors when you compare it to GIF, increased transparency, smaller size than GIF. Cons, it is still not smaller than JPEG. JPEG still is on the driver's seat. And the final image format is RAW format. The name itself is very clear. What is RAW? RAW means nothing has been done. No processing has been done. Any image when not processed is called as RAW format. For example, I take a photo. The photo is not yet processed. It will remain in the RAW format. Each company has got their own proprietary RAW formats like CR2, CRW for Canon, NEF for Nikon cameras, PEF for Pentax digital cameras. And that's it. This session is over. We have seen about 5 digital image formats. TIFF is tagged image file format. JPEG, Joint Photographic Experts Group format. GIF, graphics interchange format. Portable network graphics format. And finally, RAW format. I hope the session was interesting and useful. I'll come back to you with more inputs and sessions, contents in the near future. Thank you very much. I'll come back to you. If you like the content, please give like and subscribe to the content as well. If you have any questions, suggestions, inputs, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. Thank you.